Hi there, my name is Mike Montgomery, and today I'd like to show you how I built this DIY last name sign that I built as a wedding gift for a friend. These are awesome, obviously, for weddings, but also for housewarming gifts, maybe a baby shower, all kinds of stuff. Plus, they don't take a ton of tools, so let's get started.
So before I could really do anything, I needed to design the sign. Also, this is what I'm going to be using as a cutting template. So I just scrolled through fonts until I found one that I liked, and then played around with the positioning of everything until I got everything where I wanted it. Then I could print everything out and start spray gluing all of my letters to some half-inch MDF. I chose a pretty difficult font to cut out for my first attempt at this. Maybe if this is your first time doing bandsaw or scroll saw work, choose a font with less serifs, because I found out this wasn't super easy. Once I had everything spray glued on, I cut the rough size out on the jigsaw, then started cutting things out with the scroll saw. I found that cutting long swooping curves on the scroll saw was actually pretty tough. Because the blade is so thin, it doesn't really want to take a straight line or a long swooping arch very smoothly. So after a while of being frustrated, I happened to break my blade, so I figured it was a good time to switch to the bandsaw. Now I just got this new Ryobi benchtop bandsaw, which was perfect for this. The blade wasn't huge, the bed wasn't huge, but I didn't need it. It was a small project, and it worked great for all of these small curves. Although I did go back to the scroll saw for all of my inside curves. A bandsaw can't cut the inside of letters like on A's and E's, so I did use the scroll saw for that, and it worked perfectly. So obviously, I started out with the bigger letters to try and get the hang of everything. Then I switched over to the smaller letters, which I will say were tough. All of these fine details and super small curves were pretty tough, especially for my first time really doing any letter work on the bandsaw. But I was able to get pretty good results. Obviously, not as good as you would get with a CNC or a machine, but pretty decent.
Now, while I finish cutting out all of these letters on the bandsaw, let me talk about this week's sponsor, Audible. Audible has the largest and best selection of audiobooks online. Not only do they have the best titles available, but they've also got the best readers with the best performances. There are titles for literally every genre out there, whether it's thriller, romance, drama, mystery, science, it's all out there. I've been listening to audiobooks on Audible now for the past few months, and I'm a huge fan. This week I was listening to Astrophysics for People in a Hurry by Neil deGrasse Tyson. This book was really amazing because it took a lot of concepts and a ton of ideas that I was really unfamiliar with but wanted to learn about, and broke it down to a really simple level that someone who is not an astrophysicist could understand. Not only was the book read by Neil deGrasse Tyson himself, who has just about the best voice in the world, but the book is written in a way that, like I said, it's easy to understand and, you know, comprehend. So if you haven't already, go down to the link in the description, audible.com/modernbuilds, to get your free 30-day trial and your first audiobook on us. Once again, that is audible.com/modernbuilds for a free 30-day trial and your first book free. Thanks, Audible.
So all my letters are cut out at this point, and I needed to spray a few coats of black paint as a primer coat. MDF soaks up a lot of paint, and this pure gold Rust-Oleum isn't cheap. So I figured I'd throw on a few coats of the 99-cent black paint before I sprayed on the $8 cans of gold paint. While the letters were drying, I moved over to making the base. And I'm making that out of a piece of 3/4 maple plywood. After I cut it to width on the table saw, I moved over to the circular saw to cut it to length. Obviously, you could make a circular saw cut on both of these with a straight edge, and it would work totally fine. This masking tape, though, is a really good trick for avoiding tear out when you're using plywood. To cover up all the edges, I got some iron-on edge banding. That way, the plies weren't visible, and it really just classed everything up a little bit. I just took a razor blade out of a utility knife to flush up all of that edge banding to the rest of the surface. Then I got my sander and started with 150 grit, then sanded up to 220 grit. Once everything was nice and smooth, I put on a couple coats of Minwax stain. This color is called Provincial, and I'll have links to all of the products and materials I used in the written article linked in the description. Here I put on a couple coats of Danish oil as a clear finish. So when I went to the print shop, he told me that each of the templates were only going to cost about $2 to print. So I printed a couple of them. That way, if I messed up any of the letters, I would have extras to make extra letters with. But it also gave me reference points so that I could make baselines with masking tape for all of my letters. This was really nice. It made sure that everything was A, going on straight, but it also let me make a couple reference points, like the center of the board or where certain letters needed to start. That way I was confident that everything was going where it needed to go, and I could focus on just making sure things were going on straight. I chose hot glue to attach my letters, but you could use CA glue, epoxy. Really, there's a ton of options. There were a couple parts where I had to mend or weld letters together where I had to split them on the bandsaw, so I just used a little bit of wood filler, then some spray paint on a Q-tip to blend that all in. Finally, all that was left to do was install the hanging wire, and then secondly, I hot glued the wedding invitation that I got sent to the back of it. I just thought it could be a cool little memento to have on the back. And that was it. I could go ahead and hang it up and check it out. Now, obviously, the letters aren't perfect, the paint job isn't perfect, but I guess that's one of the cool things about making it by hand. You can tell that actually someone put time and effort into it, opposed to a CNC where everything would be perfect. I guess it just depends on how you look at it.
So I hope you guys enjoyed this project. It was fun for me to make, and it was really cool to give as a gift to a couple friends who just got married. I know it's been a little bit since I've put out new content, and that is because I've been prepping, because starting now, I am posting a new project video every week for at least a while. I want to be able to put out as much content for you guys as possible, and I think putting myself on a weekly schedule is the best way to do that. So make sure, if you're not already, hit that subscribe button, and if you're interested in hitting that little bell for notifications, that way you can stay updated every time I post a new video, be sure and do that as well. I want to give one more big thanks to Audible for sponsoring this video and allowing me to make these videos and do what I love. Be sure and go to audible.com/modernbuilds and get your free 30-day trial and your first book free. If you guys enjoyed this project, I'd love it if you hit that thumbs up and leave me a comment if you guys have any questions or ideas on neat projects. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next week on Modern Builds.